Welcome back, everybody. This is definitely one of the coolest parts of the whole DMEXCO for years. You see our hot seat, our hot chair here, and we'll be grilling a person that is well known in the industry. He's a man who's working for SAP's Global Innovation Strategy Group. He crafts future outlooks, strategies, products, and he drives moonshots for SAP. I'm dying to see how he's doing that. And in 2017, he was named one of the 100 most innovative minds in Germany by Handelsblatt. This guy is coming straight from, now listen carefully, Sao Paulo. So he just landed here about 1.5 hours ago in Cologne to be here on that seat, to get grilled from me. And I'm dying to see how he's doing on his chair. He is the chief designer and futurist for SAP's Innovation Center Network and chief innovation officer. I had to read that because that was so long. Please welcome and give a warm hand to Martin Wezowski.
All right, hey.
You're looking good, mate. You're looking good. You can have a seat.
That looks
Enjoy
good.
It.
Oh, yeah.
So how's it? Is it warm, cozy?
I love it.
Yeah?
What happens now?
He looks bloody relaxed. That's quite incredible from him. But anyway, do you know that our current chancellor, in her former times, was sitting on that chair, Miss Merkel. So it's a very famous position you're taking here.
I'm telling you, in the next decade, we will have a designer as a prime minister somewhere in Europe.
You're taking away my questions. Can you stop that? No, I'm just kidding. Okay. So, cool. Just for the audience to understand how this hot chair works. So, he's not allowed to say yes, no. He's not allowed to call anybody on his mobile. So, I hope that switch off.
It's off.
And he needs to be very sharp in his answers. 2 or 3 sentences, then it's done. If he's not going to do that, he knows what's going to happen. Yeah? Okay, how do you feel? All good?
Good.
Ready to go?
Yes.
Good. So I'm standing next to you in order to be sure you really listen and know what I'm asking you. Okay. Shall we start?
Yeah.
Okay. So you're a punk rocker. Why can punk rock be compared to the modern business of today?
Because, you know, punk rockers, as soon as they see a grown-up, something established, they say, you know, basically, up yours, we can do it differently, and by the way, we can do it regardless what you think about it, if we can or not. And that's transformation.
Okay. Please decrypt for the audience the term U-machine.
The U-machine, it's the most empathic symbiosis between human ingenuity and machine intelligence. We will live together with machines. We are machines. We are augmented by machines. We will augment machines. It's not machine learning. It's not human learning. It's human-machine learning.
Why will the future be superhuman?
Well, because it already is. We use technology to do stuff we absolutely couldn't do without technology. And that's going to escalate exponentially. So we already are living in a superhuman future.
Why will design work disappear to automation soon?
Design will disappear to automation, at least the design of simple stuff like gadgets and simple services. Design of complex systems belongs to human ingenuity.
Why should punk rock values and attitudes be applied to the business as usual in organizations?
Because punk rock and rock and roll have the creative confidence. The confidence to ask, shit, we cannot do this, right? Who in this room knows how to do it? Nobody? Good, let's do this. Business doesn't.
How can we move traditional handmade design to automated design?
Handmade design, well, crafts and arts are very different thing than design. Design answers questions, and machines can do it sometimes better. Art asks questions, and human does that better.
Almost in time. Give us 3 bullet points as main ingredients to design relationships.
Relationships are the most important thing. You design how you want to be perceived on a market. What's the relation? What do people feel for you? The product, services, and the features and the data that will follow. That's easy.
Science fiction movies show designed futures. Please rank the following films how realistic they are, from most realistic to least realistic. Okay, number 1, iRobot. Number 2, Ex Machina. Number 3, Black Mirror.
Ex Machina, iRobot, Black Mirror.
Why number 1? Ex Machina?
Because it's happening already now. I don't like the ending, because we will live in love with our machines rather than kill each other. But all the way
up to there. But they killed each other. So, no, don't worry. They killed each other. They will kill each other. We'll see in number two then. Okay, why is a superhuman world a world we all want to live in?
Because we already live in that world. As I said, guys, superhumanity means that you can take decisions beyond your own bias, and you want it, right? Because you do stupid decisions. We all do that. And machines can help us beyond that.
We've seen human robots from Hanson Robotics. Still, it seems a reality far away from us. Why would you not agree with that statement?
Because, you know, you've seen the Sophia. I chatted with Sophia. It's a statement that shows a prototype of the future. And as soon as we imagine and prototype something, we make it. So it will happen.
Why can business models, ideation and imagination, not be produced by machines?
Well, not yet. Because it requires curiosity. Machines are not curious. You know, a machine that can operate on a human brain, you know, the Leonardo robot, it can never imagine to be a pizza baker. We can.
How do you add value as an innovation officer to SAP?
Because, you know, we need to be relevant 10 years from now. If you can't answer the question why you're relevant 10 years from now, you will not be. And this is what we're trying to answer.
Why will empathy and creativity always remain a challenge for machines?
Well, not always. Machines can be empathic already today, in a certain degree. Well, because it requires so many senses to come together. It's just complex programming.
Will machines ever be able to design relationships?
Yes, they already do. For example,
you're not allowed to say yes.
Damn it.
Got you.
Okay, first one. They already do. In hospitals, they can express compassion to patients, and they have more time to do it than doctors. That will change.
Tonight we have our Minister of Digital on stage here. Mm-hmm. Why will we see a high-level politician with a design background soon?
Very good question. Because designers have the ability to express futures, sometimes 2 weeks ahead when they're making a simple app, sometimes 30 years ahead when they plan travel to Mars. Politicians must have that ability.
Why is Martin the innovator more superhuman than Martin the moderator?
Well, I don't think that's true.
Well done. Thanks. That were your questions. What do you think? Did you do well?
Oh. Thank you.
You can see it's midday. They're a bit tired. But you've done really well. I've never seen anyone having so fast the answers, never in life. So you've really done really well. So what is your next step? Where are you flying to now, to Berlin? Or?
I'm flying to Berlin, Quadriga Hochschule. I will have a lecture there, longer one than this. And then I'm flying to Portugal to meet with a customer that needs to step into the future, like many of the customers there. So I will have a big keynote there.
And you'll create a moonshot for them, right?
Yes.
Ideally. So good luck for that. Martin Wezowski, thank you very much. You've done a brilliant job here on stage. Thank you, Mark. And we'll be back in about 2 minutes with our next panel.